Ladies and gentlemen, dear Susan, thank you very much for your very generous introduction. As mentioned, some 30 years ago, you introduced me to this great country. You started me along the path that's led me here today, and for that, I will always be grateful. Let me also express my gratitude to Jim, Fred, Damon, and the entire team at the Atlantic Council. You have made an exceptional contribution to strengthening the transatlantic bond. And I'm so sorry that Brent Scowcroft was not able to be with us tonight. I also understand Hillary is joining us shortly, but I would nonetheless like to pay tribute to her leadership, intellect and energy, which have served as an inspiration to us all. For over 60 years, NATO has been our collective life insurance. The Washington Treaty's key principle can be summed up as all for one and one for all. Yet, NATO is not just a military alliance. The Washington Treaty also commits all allies to strengthening their free institutions, promoting conditions of stability and well-being, and encouraging economic collaboration. Like collective defense, these two are enduring commitments. NATO was formed to defend our freedoms, personal freedom, political freedom, economic freedom. These values are more powerful than any military might. At the height of the Cold War, our nations struck a unique transatlantic deal. Protected by NATO, nations that had gone to war against each other forged closer cooperation and laid the groundwork for the European Union. As communism collapsed, NATO and the European Union opened their doors to new members, spreading freedom across Central and Eastern Europe. Former foes became friends and allies. That was the second transatlantic deal. Now, in this global century, Europe and North America face a new challenge to protect our shared values across the globe and shape the global agenda in line with those values. So we need to strike a new transatlantic deal to do more with each other, not less, to come closer, not drift apart, to turn outwards, not inwards. So how can we make our community and values stronger, wider, deeper? My long-term vision is of a transatlantic common market. So I welcome the launch of talks on a transatlantic trade and investment partnership. This will stimulate jobs, innovation, growth. And in a world where not all play by the same rules, it will ensure that we continue to set global standards.